reporters that he'd behaved reasonably and legally. Our political correspondent Helen Catch reports.
We're supposed to be more than 2 metres apart.
Dominic Cummings at his London home, insisting he did not break lockdown rules.
I think it was reasonable to travel 260 miles, Cummings, so you might have made a note about it.
I behaved reasonably and legally. Hey, little Kenny radio.
That's not equivalent, sir, is it, Mr. Cummings?
Who cares about good looks?
Country, this country got locked down on this fucking
cunt's
projection is what you're showing out for him roaming around fucking country like fucking nothing.
250 miles away at a family property in Durham.
Dominic Cummings should have done the right thing, he should have resigned, but now that he hasn't, Boris Johnson must show leadership and he must remove him from office immediately. But we now know from what's been said on the BBC this morning that the government in London have been aware of this for weeks. So why have we not been told about this? Why has Boris Johnson not recognised that this is something that would be seen by millions of people as being unacceptable?
Mr. Cummings is understood to have left London with his wife, who developed coronavirus symptoms, and their young son.
They ask these questions, and yet we know fucking why.
Because
the government is corrupt.
Under guidance, anyone who
knows from within can get away with it.
Is told to stay at home for 14 days. Durham Constabulary says that on the 31st of March, officers were made aware of reports that an individual had travelled from London to Durham and was present at an address in the city. The force said officers made contact with the owners of that address, who confirmed that the individual in question was present and was self-isolating in part of the house. In a statement, Downing Street said that as he was likely to become ill too, it was essential for Dominic Cummings to ensure his young child could be properly cared for. His sister volunteered to help, so he went to a house near to, but separate from his extended family in case their help was needed. The statement goes on, his actions were in line with coronavirus guidelines. Mr. Cummings believes he behaved reasonably and legally.
What, like his
Downing
projections?
Downing Street has also denied that Mr. Cummings or his family were spoken to about this by police. Earlier this month, Professor Neil Ferguson quit his role on the government's scientific advisory committee, SAGE, after The Telegraph reported he'd broken lockdown rules by letting his married lover visit him at home. Dr. Catherine Coldwood resigned as Scotland's chief medical officer after visiting her second home twice. Some Conservative MPs
one
have come out
for
in
one for another,
Cummings. Labour, though, has said
government
the country deserves
people,
answers. Either way, more questions are still likely to be asked. Helen Catt, BBC News.
That's what you tell us, but nothing will be asked.
I'm joined by our political correspondent, Nick
Nothing
Irby,
will be asked.
And Nick, as Helen says, lots of questions still to be answered.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, telling us, let's fucking see. Let's see you all round the table grilling him, make an hour of that, but later on.
Exactly.
Instead of putting Coronation Street on, let's see him get grilled round the table for an hour.
Whether the government considers that he followed them completely. Now, we have had that statement from Downing Street in which they are clear that they think he acted within the rules. We've heard from Mr. Cummings.
They think he acted within the rules.
Exactly.
Oh, they will do. They protect each other.
The guidance for people who are showing symptoms of coronavirus is to stay at home in all circumstances. Now, we do know that Downing Street is pointing towards some guidance that came from the Deputy Chief Medical Officer for England saying there might be circumstances in which you need help with childcare. But there are still those questions of whether that 260-mile journey from London to Durham was completely necessary. There's also that broader question of...
Well, it wasn't necessary for any fucker else. Why should it be for fucking some fun? Someone who works for Parliament?
Looking at this, thinking, well, I've followed the rules.
Different rule for them, innit?
I'd love to have done something similar.
Enforce all the draconian on us and do fucking the opposite themselves.
The government has to
pure scum
in the next few days is whether this undermines its very own messaging, which it's praised the public for sticking so strongly to.
So I suppose that is the heart of the question, isn't it? That
public shouldn't be praised for sticking to
Downing Street says that he behaved legally.
Public have acted like sheer fucking idiots.
Not be so much about the letter of the guidelines as the spirit of them.
Absolutely. It's about both. It's about whether the government was...
The bogeyman's coming to get you. The bogeyman.
The rest of us were. You know,
fear the bogeyman.
spoken her piece there about the chief medical officer in Scotland who was forced to resign, Catherine Calderwood.
The coronavirus.
The Scottish government initially defended her, but it was when Nicola Sturgeon had to stand up and face a barrage of questions from journalists saying, well, hold on a minute, this person stayed at home, this person missed the funeral, this person missed the wedding, all the while this was going on, you know, in that case, the chief medical officer, but in this case, the Prime Minister's chief advisor, were in some ways interpreting the rules in a way that worked for them. In many ways, it's about how the public react to this. You know, it's clear Downing Street want to hold on to Mr. Cummings. We've had senior ministers tweeting all afternoon saying that he was right to do what he did. I suspect the big question now, though, is the public...
Boris Johnson will be on phone to him saying, fucking hell, mate, you fucked up, man. Couldn't you have just kept yourself
still
a bit more?
We should all stay at home whenever Eden possible.
And you messed up, mate. That's what Boris will be saying to him.
Don't go out.
Okay, Nick, don't go away. We'll come back to you just
a bit like what royal family would have said to Prince Andrew. Fucking hell, Andrew. You fucking messed up, mate.
The government is facing more questions over its plans to introduce a 14-day quarantine for people arriving in the UK. From June the 8th, travellers will have to self-isolate for 2 weeks and could face fines of £1,000 if they break the rules. France has said that visitors arriving from the UK will also have to self-isolate for 14 days from the same date.
Complete fucking retards.
Airlines and travel companies are worried it could damage their businesses even further. The UK government says the measures are designed to stop a second wave of coronavirus. Our correspondent Simon Jones is at Heathrow Airport, and he
said, "Oh, you said there's going to be a second wave. It's only government who said there's going to be a second wave,
didn't it?" Heathrow is currently being affected. Normally, at this time of year, at the start of the half-term getaway, they'd be dealing with around 250,000 passengers each.